In this video, we will explore the principles of the Softmax function, which plays a crucial role in multi-class classification, and see how it is applied to multi-class problems. Before explaining multi-class classification, let's first take a look at binary classification. Binary classification involves distinguishing between two classes, such as classifying as positive or negative, or normal and failure. In binary classification, we use the sigmoid function as the activation function, producing values between 0 and 1. This equation shows the sigmoid function where when x is small, it approaches 0, and as x increases, it converges to 1. The values obtained through the sigmoid function, between 0 and 1, are not just simple numbers, but can be interpreted as probabilities. For binary classification, we use binary cross-entropy, which we discussed in the previous cross-entropy video, as the loss function. Multi-class classification involves classifying into three or more classes. Examples include recognizing handwritten digits from 0 to 9, or identifying objects in a photo. In multi-class classification, we use the softmax function as the activation function, which outputs the probability for each class. This equation represents the softmax function, which takes the logits as input, transforms them using the exponential function, and then divides by the sum of all values to present them in the form of probabilities. Additionally, for multi-class classification, we use categorical cross-entropy as the loss function. For more details on this, please refer to the previous cross-entropy video. Let's first take a look at logit score. The next diagram shows part of the structure of a perceptron. When two values, x1 and x2, are input, they are each multiplied by their corresponding weights, omega-1 and omega-2, and then the bias B is added. In this way, the raw output from the final layer of the artificial neural network, before the activation function is applied, is called the logit score. We can express this as a formula, which can be represented in matrix form, and it reflects the relative likelihood for each class. Now, let's assume a multi-class classification problem with three classes, A, B, and C. The logit scores for A, B, and C are calculated as the linear result of the input values, weights, and biases corresponding to each class. A higher logit score means a higher likelihood for that class. However, since logit scores are not normalized, they cannot be directly interpreted as probabilities. Therefore, the logit scores are transformed into probabilities between 0 and 1 using the softmax function. Now let's take a look at the softmax function. Softmax is an activation function widely used in multi-class classification problems, and it converts the given input values into probabilities. It is typically applied in the output layer of a neural network and represents the probability of the input belonging to a particular class. The softmax function is defined by the following equation, where Z represents the logit score for each class. It converts each logit score into an exponential value, then normalizes by dividing by the total sum, resulting in a probability value between 0 and 1. Also, the total sum of the probabilities for all classes is 1. Now let's look at an example to see how the softmax function is used. In a multi-class classification problem with three classes, A, B, and C, let's assume that the neural network outputs logit scores of 2.0, 1.0, and 0.1 for A, B, and C, respectively. Using the softmax function, we convert these logit scores into exponential values, and then divide by the total sum to calculate the probabilities. So, the probability for class A is 0.659, for class B is 0.242, and for class C is 0.099. If we add the probabilities for all classes, we can see that the total is 1. In other words, based on the logit scores, when we calculate the probabilities through softmax, the probability for A, B, and C is 0.7, 0.2, and 0.1, respectively. Next, through one-hot encoding, we select the class with the highest predicted probability, assign 1 to that class, and assign 0 to the remaining classes. Since A has the highest probability, we assign 1 to A, and assign 0 to the remaining classes, B and C. So, in the end, it is converted into the class label, 1, 0, 0. In multi-class classification, we use categorical cross-entropy as the loss function. This equation represents categorical cross-entropy, where Y represents the actual class and P of Y represents the predicted probability. So, we substitute the one-hot encoded values into Y and the probabilities calculated through softmax into PY. As a result, all the incorrect classes become 0 and are eliminated, and only the correct class is considered in the loss function calculation. Therefore, cross-entropy focuses on the correct class to calculate the loss, which reduces unnecessary calculations and makes it more efficient, which is why it is used as the loss function in multi-class classification problems. To summarize the content on softmax, in binary classification, we use the sigmoid function as the activation function and binary cross-entropy as the loss function. After that, the class labels are given as 0 and 1. In multi-class classification, we use the softmax function as the activation function and categorical cross-entropy as the loss function. After that, the class labels are given in one-hot encoded form.